Hello everyone, you are with Sagarwar to study structural design patterns. I am going to take you through decorator pattern. We are going to see what is decorator pattern, why to use it, when to use it, and how to use it. So let's start. Why is it a structural design pattern? Because it wraps the existing structure for its enhancements, and then itself forms a new structure. To understand this technically, please stay with me till the end of this video. Now understand that every design pattern is meant to solve a problem. So which problem does the decorator pattern solve? Let's take a look at it. Consider a scenario where we want to build a food maker that, given a requirement, produces the appropriate food. When building it programmatically, we are going to start by creating an interface, iFoodMaker, that has a method prepare, accepting type as an input and food as an output. We are now going to build our food maker by implementing iFoodMaker. So we have to define prepare method now with the logic that helps food maker to build the food. So for now, let's assume we wrote a program that gathers ingredients, then prepares the food, and at the end returns the food. Now since the code is ready, let's see how the consumer will interact with our interface. For now, let's assume the consumer creates the instance of food maker and then invokes prepare method on it. I believe our first food maker is ready to sell. But hey, what happens if in future there is a new requirement that says whenever food is ready, the food maker has to play a sound? Now we have multiple options to achieve this requirement. So let's see them one by one. Approach 1, where we decide to modify the existing food maker to accommodate this requirement. Now though this looks simpler, there might be multiple challenges associated with this approach. The first challenge could be the food maker might not have the appropriate hardware to play the music, or we still want to sell the food maker without the music to few of the clients, but by modifying the existing food maker makes it difficult. Now let's see the another approach to build this requirement. We can create new food maker that also implements the same interface, iFoodMaker. And inside the prepare, it can define not only to prepare the food, but to also play the music. Now the benefit this approach adds is that now you can sell food maker as well as new food maker to the separate clients. But it also carries a drawback to having duplicate code in food maker as well as in new food maker. So this may not be the wise choice yet. Hang on, we are not done yet. The drawbacks of approach 1 and approach 2 have brought us to approach 3, where we inherit from the food maker and then we override the prepare method to call the preparation method of the food maker itself, and after that play the music. Now this way the food maker is still preparing the food and the new food maker is just playing the sound after the food maker prepares the food. This looks to be a very good option, but hang on, this is still not the right choice. Approach 3 also carries some set of drawbacks. The first problem is that the food maker is not responsible to play the music. It should strictly focus on preparing the food. Second problem is that the inheritance will only solve the problem for food maker. What I mean is, let's say tomorrow we have premium food maker and one of the clients says, I want to have a music for this premium food maker as well. In that case, we will end up in creating new premium food maker that inherits from premium food maker. If you analyze the problem, the more food makers we are going to have in future and the more requirements that will ask us to add music on top of it, we are going to end up in creating as many derived classes as we have food makers, and that too just play a music. You must be thinking that it would have been nice when we have a single decorator on top of all the food makers that can just play music for them. Before we jump to any solution, let's try to note down all the problems which we have observed so far. The first problem is that existing entity cannot be modified because it may not have the appropriate resources. The second problem is that existing entity cannot be modified because it breaks its single responsibility. Third, existing entity cannot be modified because it may impact the other consumers which might not be expecting this change. And the last, existing entity can be cloned and the new feature can be added to this cloned entity. This works, but this adds the additional overhead of maintaining duplicate code. The solution which we are expecting here is decorator pattern. So coming back to our original example where we had a food maker to produce the food, we will now apply a wrapper, which is also called as a decorator, on top of the food maker, and we will call it as voice food maker. The role of this voice food maker will be to utilize food maker to produce the food and also to play the music whenever food is ready. Programmatically, applying decorator pattern is very easy. You just have to create a voice food maker class which also implements the same interface as that of food maker. Now understand that voice food maker is just a decorator. It doesn't have its own logic to produce the food, but it will expect one of the real food maker as an input while the consumer wants to consume it. So we are going to create a private member for the food maker and we are going to accept its value from the constructor. Now since we are part of the same interface, we are going to define the prepare method. The definition of voice food maker for the prepare method will be, we utilize the real food maker to produce the food and then play the music, and at the end it will return the food. Now have your careful attention over here. Since we are accepting the food maker instance from the constructor and the voice food maker is totally depending on the value of this food maker to produce the food, the consumers can utilize this voice food maker for any of the real food makers. It could be a regular food maker, it could be a premium food maker. Let's try to see the consumption pattern of this decorator. Let's say client A says that I want a food maker, but I don't want to play a music. So we'll just create a regular food maker instance and we'll invoke prepare method for it. The client B says that I want to use food maker, but I also want to have the play music functionality for it. For that, we are now going to create a voice food maker. We will pass the instance of new food maker to it so that the food produced will be by food maker, and also we will get the music. Now the client C comes and says, hey, I want to use premium food maker and I also want to have music functionality. For that, we will create voice food maker and we will pass the instance of premium food maker so that the food will be produced by premium food maker and will also have the music functionality. This looks amazing, right? Let's try to understand decorator pattern from the block diagram. So we have a consumer and we have a product. The consumer consumes the product in a regular way. But now, whenever there will be a requirement to have some kind of good to have functionality on top of this product, where the functionality is not the responsibility of the product, but it is something which is demanded by the client. For that, we'll create a decorator on top of the product. The job of the decorator will be to consume the product for its core functionality and then invoke its own logic to fulfill the demand that client has specified. I think we are going good. Now let's take a moment to note down all the advantages that we have observed so far. First, decorator pattern helps to maintain single responsibility of the original classes. Secondly, it helps to support many operations for the entity on demand basis. And third, it helps to avoid unnecessary use of inheritance just to achieve good to have features. Also take the note of other examples where decorator pattern can be useful. Decorator pattern can be useful where you want to add caching on top of your data layer. The second example could be adding logging functionality every time an entity performs any operation. And the third, decorator pattern can be useful where you want to send notification to multiple social networks at the same time. Now, when everything looks so simple, you must be wondering, when should I use decorator pattern? For that, you have to ask a question to yourself. Do you have one or more similar set of entities for which there is a demand to add good to have feature on top of it, and you do not want to change existing entities? If the answer to this question is yes, you should use decorator pattern. Well, that's it. I hope this was helpful. And now you understand decorator pattern. And as I always mention, this is just a starter video. This is not going to make you master of all the design patterns. So keep reading more about this online. Try to get more hands-on experience on decorator pattern. Try to get in-depth knowledge about decorator pattern. I am here to bring all the complex concepts and present them in as simple way as possible. I hope Optimus Growth Channel helps you to build your knowledge and let you build knowledge for others. Please subscribe for upcoming videos and do share all of them with your friends. Thank you. Thank you so much.